Welcome to our St. John's Parish family on this sixth Sunday of Easter. We especially welcome all who are visiting with us. At this Mass, we remember in a special way Ellen Caulfield. Please stand and give a sign of welcome to those around you. We begin our liturgy singing number 753 in the Gather Hymnal. All are welcome. Number 753 in Gather.
Let us build a house where love can dwell and all can see.
Of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Dear brothers and sisters, welcome to this celebration of the sixth Sunday of Easter. We are gathering once again here in the presence of the Lord, us here in the church, and all those of you who are following us online. We send our love and blessings to all those who are in any way going through difficult times in their lives and all those who are struggling, all of our homebound. Please know that you are very much included in the intention of this Mass, and you are very much being prayed for every time when we gather as a community of faith. Jesus will challenge us once again today with one of the most important Christian themes, and that is his message of love. So for those moments when we have in any way lacked in that commandment ourselves, lacked in living it fully in our lives, let us ask for the Lord's pardon and mercy.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us into everlasting life.
Glory, glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins
us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of our risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may also always hold to in what we do. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Peter entered, Cornelius met him and, falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up, I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out on the Gentiles also, for they could hear them speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit even as we have?" He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, the word of the Lord.
Our psalm is number 66 in the Gather Hymnal. May God bless us in his mercy. Number 66 in Gather.
May God bless us in his mercy. May God bless us in his mercy. Good.
reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment: love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask of the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you: love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, as we listen to the readings of today, it's not that difficult to decode and to realize what is the main theme of the Word of God on this Sunday, as we are nearing the celebration of the ascension of the Lord to heaven and then sending of the Holy Spirit on the Pentecost. And that word certainly is love. Now, that has been the theme in all the readings of this Sunday. But I also wanted to add to it one passage that was written 2,000 years ago by a young man who at one point in his life was not only filled with hatred and animosity, but very instrumental in the passing and death of the first martyr and deacon, Saint Stephen. And that man was Saul. Later, he took name Paul. Today we know him as one of the greatest saints of Christianity and one of the greatest messengers of God's love. In his first letter to the Corinthians, in the 13th chapter, he wrote this: "If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong and a clashing cymbal. And if I have a gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge of the world, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing." And then later he continued like this: "Love is patient, love is kind, it is not jealous, it is not pompous, it is not inflated, it is not rude. It doesn't seek its own interest. It is not quick-tempered, rejoices always in the truth." You may know the reading. It's one of the most popular readings for the weddings. But also, all of our gatherings when we celebrate love. I wanted to begin with that particular passage because it illustrates how Paul's understanding of what love truly is and where it comes from developed in his own life. Throughout the readings of today, Jesus is presenting to himself to us as love. And he is sharing with us the love that there is within the Holy Trinity. And when he's presenting that concept of love to us, he's not asking us to self-generate love. He's asking us to be inspired and touched by love of Almighty God and take piece of it into the world of today. And this is what exactly Paul discovered. Him and countless saints throughout 2,000 years of Christianity. They discovered that they themselves cannot truly generate that God-like love in this world. But if they make themselves the instruments of God's love, they can do the greatest things in life. Once we do understand it, dear brothers and sisters, that kind of heavy burden, especially in the times of difficulties and struggles and problems and conflicts, is kind of lifted from our shoulders. Because our prayer during that time should be not that we love, but that we open ourselves more to the love of Almighty God, and to that God would help us to love others. We know it. We have experienced it in so many contexts of our lives. At times it can be so, so difficult. But if we do come, if we do gather, if we are inspired by the Word of God, and then if we are nourished by the Eucharist, then we can, you, me, each and every one of us, little by little, in various moments of our life, be those life-giving instruments of God's love. And that's what we desire. That's who we want to be. Earlier today, in two separate masses, and then 3 weeks ago, in another two masses, 78 children from our parish received their first Holy Communion. This is actually the fourth Mass on this day here in the parish on this Saturday evening. In each and every one of them, Jesus nourished those who gathered, with his word, and then he descended from heaven above here on this altar and gave himself as the greatest gift in the Eucharist. But those celebrations of the first Holy Communion were particularly very special. They were precious, not only because children remind us about innocence and love and how we were when we were little, but also because they don't fully comprehend yet how difficult and challenging and at times problematic life can be. But they put themselves in the presence of Almighty God, and they receive that Eucharist with the trust that they are surrounded by loving family members and friends, by their parents, their siblings, their grandparents, that through them they receive love each and every day, and that in their innocence of their hearts and minds, they receive the Eucharist. Not that they fully understand it or comprehend it, but because they received it as a gift. If those children, their brothers and sisters, those 78 in our parish, can inspire us, that would be fantastic. Not only that, we, as we gather, we appreciate and we recognize the importance of Eucharist and coming to Mass and listening to the Word of God, but in our own hearts, in our own minds, in our own life, each and every day, we try to rekindle that beauty, that innocence, and that total dependence on others and on God. That's the way God made us. He placed us in the community of our parish, community of our family, surrounded us with our friends, gave us all those sources of love through which he nourishes us each and every day. But then he brings us here. He brings us to his very presence so we can listen to him, that we can be nourished by him, and then sent in his name to go into the world of today. So let us, dear brothers and sisters, as we gather today, be grateful for that gift of boundless love of Almighty God. One of the greatest outcomes of it is the fact that we have woken up this morning to another day. And God willing, tomorrow we'll get another chance. He loves us, he blesses us, he sustains us. Everything that we have ever done and accomplished in his love and in our life came as the result of that love. But he wants a bit of it back, not for himself, but for our brothers and sisters. So may this week be once again filled for us, the brothers and sisters, with many moments and opportunities when we'll realize and acknowledge how God loves us, how many countless blessings we have received, and how we can share some of those with the brothers and sisters and with the world of today, which needs that love and those blessings so, so very much. Amen. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, was incarnate with the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered dead and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Jesus said, "Whatever you ask the Father in my name will be granted. Therefore, let us place our needs before our loving and eternal God."
Our response is, "Lord, hear our prayer." That those searching for faith in a chaotic world encounter Christ through the extended love, acceptance, and respect from every member of the church, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations come together to fix oppressive political and economic systems in our world that cause suffering and war, and for the cessation of all current wars and conflicts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Inspire the work of artists, writers, musicians, and other creative persons who bring hope to the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open our senses to the wonders of your creation and the joy of Christ alive in our world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those soon to graduate will live in Christ's love through their service to the human family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That there be an increase in the answer to the call to the priesthood, diaconate, and religious life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all those who live with illness, both physical and mental, may feel Christ's comforting arms of love, especially Barbara Hudson, Susan Hirma, George Petruncio, and Raymond Casalac. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died find the peace and grace that only Christ can give, especially Christopher Bedford. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Ellen Caulfield, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, you put forward the greatest commandment, love one another as I love you. Receive our prayers that our hearts might expand and love for the world might deepen. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Let us all sing now together number 756, called "Morning Has Broken," the great Gaelic hymn. Number 756 in Gather.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the word. Sweet the rains new fall, sunlit from heaven, like the first dew fall on the first grass. Praise for the sweetness of the wet garden, sprung in completeness where his feet pass. Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light Eden saw play. Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's recreation of the new
pray, dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, to Christ our Lord. To Jesus, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and a chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and died in your mercy, especially Ellen Caulfield and all of our loved ones, family members, and friends. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with blessed apostles, with Saint Peter, Saint Paul, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now let us pray to our Heavenly Father in the words our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. And by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit. Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
forget to look around us. Some days we can't see the joy that surrounds us. So caught up inside ourselves, we take when we should give. So for tonight, we pray for what we know can be. And on this day, we hope for what we still can see. It's up to us to be the change. And even though we all can still do more, there's so much to be thankful for. Even with our differences, there is a place we're all connected. Each of us can find each other's light. So for tonight, we pray for what we know can be. And on this day, we hope for what we still can't see. It's up to us to be the change. And even though this world needs so much more, there's so much to be
turn to number 628 in the Gather Hymnal and join in singing No Greater Love. Number 628.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of our risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Once again, our congratulations to all of our children and young people who receive First Holy Communion. In about 2 weeks, we'll have a beautiful celebration of another important sacrament, which young people receive, the sacrament of confirmation. On Monday evening, they will receive the sacrament of reconciliation. So let us keep our young people in our prayers. We need them. They are the future, and they continue to inspire us. So may they, in this world, which is often filled with so much not love, not true love of God, then may they thrive under God's protection. We entrust all of you, ourselves, and all of our loved ones to the loving protection of our mother. During this month of May, we'll crown Blessed Virgin Mary at 8 o'clock Mass on Sunday with the entire Rosary Society. So we make this month of Mary another extra effort to really pray the Rosary and to increase our devotion to our Mother, Blessed Virgin Mary. I will ask you to take a bulletin with you. There is a lot of important information, including our Register, Renew, and Grow initiative. Now, it's the sixth Sunday of Easter. That means that we have been in this for about 6 weeks. And I hope by now every one of you present here today already had an opportunity to re-register and to give us all the correct information, especially your contact information. In about 2 weeks, we'll conclude this first phase within which I hope every one of you has had an opportunity to re-register. And then we'll shift our attention towards those brothers and sisters who are not with us as often. Obviously, as time goes, I will give you many more reasons why we need to do this, including improvement of our ministries and also fiscal responsibility when it comes to spending money and contacting people who perhaps registered many, many years ago and now they are maybe not with us or not with us for a long, long time. So our parish database is seriously outdated, and we truly needed to do this to renew and grow, because those are two very important aspects of this initiative. Also, on the June 19th, our young people from the parish, our youth group, will be attending a statewide youth rally. And we invite the young people from our parish to consider it and join it. But also we ask for some chaperones, some adults who can join us on that day to make it nice and special for the young people. Obviously, when they meet other friends who are friends of Jesus and they develop new friendships in the context of their parish, their faith, their diocese, or this local church, that's also very important for them also. And now please receive this final blessing. The Lord be with you.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing.
Our loving and eternal God, may your family always rejoice together over the mysteries of redemption they have celebrated, and grant its members the perseverance to attain the effects that flow from them. And may Almighty God bless you, guide you, and keep you always in his loving care, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We are sent forth singing number 131 in spirit and song. I know that my Redeemer lives. Number 131 in spirit and song.